So you guys haven't been beat yet?
No, not yet. We were hoping that could come.
good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We welcome you here to Memphis Mike Rose Stadium. My name is El Conductor. I normally don't do commentary on these games, and I won't do a lot here tonight, but since this is an away game, we're on sort of a skeleton crew, and so you've got me as your announcer tonight. I'll try to keep it friendly and normal. I'll do the best I can. But we basically came down on the bus over here on the long 5-hour trip to Memphis. We made it here in plenty of time. We've gotten set up. We have a guest cameraman working with us tonight, a local boy named Michael. So we'll see how well that goes. If you'll be forgiving with us, hopefully we'll be able to get you the action as smoothly as you're used to with a game that comes from here or up in the stadium or wherever the Chattanooga and CFC may be. I don't have a roster for either team, and I don't have a lineup, so you're not going to get any of that. You can hopefully hear that from the PA announcer, but if you can't, you don't have to message me on the YouTube chat and ask me who did what. I'm probably not going to be able to tell you. I'm actually not going to do a whole lot of commentary. We're just going to let the Chattahooligans be the soundtrack, kind of what we did most of last year. So that's kind of what you get. And but we are happy to bring you this game, and we hope you enjoy it. All right, we're waiting for the teams to take the field. You'll probably see the color of the scoreboard change here in just a second because I'm not really sure what everybody's wearing, so I'll probably be fiddling with the colors on the scoreboard. But I got the names right, so that'll help us out at least for the first couple of minutes.
Bring him out, bring him out.
You probably heard the Chattahooligans giving Memphis goalie Chris Baker a hard time there. Longtime Chattahooligan viewers and followers will remember that Chris Baker has been a backup goalie for Chattanooga for the past 2 years, moved over to Memphis once they started up a new team, and has frankly seen a lot more minutes. And so I don't think he actually got into the game in the Memphis game in Chattanooga, but I expect we'll probably see him some here, and so the Chattahooligans are certainly getting ready for that. Well, it seems like I'm not going to get off very early tonight. You could barely hear the PA announcer, so you're not going to be able to hear very much, folks at home. I'll do my best to keep you updated on who did what. Oh, it looks like I need to change the color of Memphis, so let me do that for a second. Goal on your left. We're all set to begin action here. I did not catch any of the people who were on the field. I know Tom Hossel is in goal. I recognize some of the guys on Chattanooga, but you got, you know, Juan Hernandez is there in the middle. I think Samuel Goni is over there. I see Aldo Aldridge and a bunch of other people that will, they'll probably all score tonight, so you'll get to hear their names in a minute. With a chance. Good shot from the outside. Memphis goalie able to jump on it and control it. Memphis ball. Excellent chance for Memphis there, but when he tried to push it back out to the top of the box, Chattanooga was able to get possession, push it back out to midfield. Corner for Chattanooga coming up. Our first set piece of the game. over the bar, so it's going to be a goal kick for Memphis. Brought it in, and Chattanooga challenged and was able to take it away. Chattanooga ball down the far side. Dangerous volley for Memphis there, but Chattanooga was able to clear it away. Juan Hernandez trying to gain control in the midfield. He's able to push it up. I believe that's maybe Goni that has it. And Chattanooga turns it back over, but Juan is able to get it. Now Chattanooga on the attack. Pushing it ahead. Not offsides. He's onside. He kicks. And just wide on the left. Excellent opportunity for Chattanooga, but the goalie made him take the near side and just pushed it off frame. Memphis with a shot, but over just wide. It's going to bounce freely out. It's actually not a goal kick. It's going to be a throw-in for Chattanooga. Memphis with a chance, trying to push it back into the box, and Chattanooga a little bit lazy there, but finally does clear it. The sun has gone behind some clouds, so we're actually having a little bit of relief right now. This is not too bad, but in another hour, the sun will drop down behind the trees, and we'll be completely on the light. Although they should go ahead and turn those on. Memphis with a good possession there, but just held on to the ball a little too long, let the Chattanooga defender come up and just snatch it away from him. Another turnover by Chattanooga there. Looked like they were trying to develop something, bring it up the middle, but Memphis was just too quick on the ball. Turnover for Memphis. Chattanooga tries to take it down the near side, see if they can get it ahead to a man. Goni takes it, passes it back. Heading up into the middle. Oh, nobody there for the pass. Frustrating. If you remember from the first game where these two played, Memphis was actually very good in the box, had lots of good dangerous chances in the box against Chattanooga, particularly at the end of the game as the Chattanooga defense started to wear down a little bit. But Memphis has been very strong here early, both teams trying to possess but then getting taken away from in the midfield. So still scoreless here, but this game could break open at any moment. Chattanooga with the throw-in. Let's see if they can develop this into a good scoring opportunity. No, Memphis is playing tight on defense. It causes a Chattanooga turnover. Now, some of you on the chat have mentioned how all you can hear the Chattanooga. Well, that's certainly true, but there is a little bit extra going on here. One, oh, that's a yellow card. Hold on, let me signify that with, there we go. Yellow card on Memphis. The Rogue Squadron, the supporters group for Memphis, is on the far end of the field to the far left. so not really near our microphone. Plus, typically at a game, I like to point the microphone at the Chattahooligans, and that way we know that we're going to get to hear some very entertaining commentary from the Chattahooligans. Championship, which will mean that Chattanooga will host the conference tournament in 2 weeks. Try this again. They're going to load up for another free kick from essentially the same spot as the other one. And we'll see how this one goes. Pushed it a little further into the box, but that allowed the goalie to come up and grab it. So a couple of dangerous, well, potentially dangerous set pieces for Chattanooga, both of them turned away by some good defense by Memphis. But of course, Memphis is the number two team in the conference, so you would expect them to play some pretty good defense. Memphis defender is within a few feet of the person with the ball, so they're not getting any space here. We'll see how this game goes on. Eventually, one of these two teams is going to start getting some heavy legs, so we'll see how this goes. But right now, both teams playing each other very close, very quickly. bit of a hard foul there by Matt Allen Alder. No card awarded, so it's all good. Well, Chattanooga's put together a couple of good, oh man. Oh, well, as I was saying, Chattanooga had some really good one-on-one possessions there. Was able to matriculate the ball up through the midfield, but then once it got to the last two guys, Memphis clamped down and was able to take it away. Memphis trying to set up for another shot here. Number 5 is going to take it into the box, see if he can cross it over, but no one's on. Dangerous ball there over Chattanooga defender. But then it was not much could be done with it, so Chattanooga was able to in fact clear it. Pushing it ahead. Let's see if we can do something with it. Passes. Tries to get back in position. Oh, but the pass back was frustratingly too high. I mean, he tried to one touch that one. That's always difficult. Plus, he was looking back into the sun, and you know, a half dozen other excuses I could make for him. But the result is still the same. Goal kick for Memphis. Push it ahead, the goalie had to come out to try to get it. It was a 1-on-1 with, I think that was Sindre Wello, maybe. Barely beat the goalie, but the goalie had pushed him so far to the outside that there was really no angle on the shot, and so the shot went wide. But still a pretty good opportunity for Chattanooga, very dangerous. For the fans paying attention here in the stadium, it was quite startling. Chattanooga player gets run over in midfield, so we get a little bit of a free kick. Chattanooga gonna do a quick start, trying to take it up through the midfield. Again, that storming Memphis defense is trying to collapse. See if we get an angle here on the pass back. Nope. But I think we're gonna get a corner. Yes, Chattanooga corner. Now Memphis is going to get the dangerous free kick. Sail by and make sure no mistakes were made. Three, two, one, go! Pardon me, boys! Again, Memphis with very good defense. Both these teams very athletic, not letting any space develop. You're seeing lots and lots of turnovers in this game, and that's really just because if you don't put the ball right where it needs to be for the pass, somebody's going to jump in and intercept the angle. But we do have another corner for Chattanooga. They've been putting some pressure on recently, getting a free kick and now a corner. We'll see if we can put something in the box. Well, again, a little bit too high. Basically, Memphis's line is just so tall, and they're able to get up and get that ball that there's very little margin for error. All of the free kicks and corners are having to go very high, and if they're not just right to the Chattanooga man, then odds are somebody from Memphis is going to be able to jump up and get it. Another free kick. And a quick start by Chattanooga. He's on sides. Let's see what we can get. Oh, good stop by the goalie. Good stop. Pushes it back out, and then Chattanooga kicks it wide. Chattanooga throw in. Up and right to the goalie. A little bit of a bump there by, my glasses are fogging up. I'm not sure what that was. We're going to say it was Goni. It's probably not Goni, but it was probably somebody. Chattanooga trying to draw the penalty there in the box. Memphis, aggressive, but not probably a foul. So good no call by the ref there. A little bit of acting by Chattanooga, just trying to see what they can get. Costly turnover by Chattanooga, but Memphis was forced to shoot from outside. Tommy Salsa was right there ready to scoop it up. What could have been a very dangerous opportunity was only mildly dangerous and quickly turned away. Another Chattanooga possession, trying to bring it into the box with a little cross, but just the timing was a little off. But it looks like a little bit more space is developing here when Chattanooga takes it up. I think this heat and this very high tempo play is starting to take its toll on both teams, and you're seeing the defense for Memphis maybe get a half step a little slower than they were when they started. still strong there, able to snatch it away from Chattanooga. But then they give it right back. Memphis is number 17. He's the one with the ball just there a second ago. Very good in the midfield. Actually, very strong guy. And you've seen a couple of times when Juan Hernandez or a couple of the other fellows have been trying to sort of bump him off the ball, and he's having none of that. So good job, number 17 for Memphis. You are holding your ground. Invite that guy to one of our tryouts here in the winter. A few people on chat have started to notice the quality of the field. This is a natural grass field. It's a municipal field where you see it gets a lot of play. It's a little patchy, and they put down a lot of sand to hopefully even it out, but the ball is skipping around and bouncing a little irregularly. It's certainly not a smooth surface like you would get from an artificial field. And actually, earlier in the game, you might have picked up on some of the Chattahooligans' chants, where they were sort of taunting the Memphis facility here by saying that Lowe's has grass seed. That's actually an old chant that we used to use against the Rocket City United, who also had a grass field that was used for American football during the fall and winter, and so it always had deep ruts near the sidelines. Because you never, the field never had a chance to rest and grow back. Bit of confusion as to who's going to get called for that foul. Ultimately, the center round steps in and calls a foul on Chattanooga, throw in Memphis, or probably a free kick. Yeah. So he's going to set it down right there. Oh, he's going to make him throw it in. Well, that's odd. A bit hard to see in that shot, but basically he lobbed it well over, so you didn't miss much on that. Our cameraman got distracted by one of his family members walking by and saying hello, so that sort of thing happens. Wow, well, a little bit of a defensive breakdown there. Two defensive Memphis defenders thought that the other was going to get the ball. It lazily rolled through and left it at the foot of a Chattanooga man, but he was able to kick it just a little too high over the bar. Goalie kick. Chattanooga, Memphis ball. Chattanoogans giving a little bit of trouble to the opposing coaching staff. Several coaching members have been out of the box giving coaching instructions from the sideline. You can pretty much get away with that when it's your own field. When you're on the road, refs tend to be a little bit more strict about that sort of thing. Saw a pretty good slow but wide shot there by Memphis. Tommy had to run it down, but he was able to get his hands on it, control it, and turn it into Chattanooga possession, taking it away from Memphis. Oh, that was almost a good chance by Chattanooga. The goalie made the right decision, came out, forced the ball away, controlled it. No shot on him. Well, the sun has dropped down now behind the trees. You can see the shadows of the trees on the field. So hopefully this oppressive heat will start to recede, and that'll pump some extra life back into this game. Oh, wow. A little bit of a defensive mistake there. He stopped it, but then slipped down, leaving the ball pretty much right at the feet of a Chattanooga man. If he could have gotten there in time, wasn't able to, so the defender just turned and punched it out. But that will be a corner for Chattanooga. Again, another corner to no one, except for Memphis, and they were able to possess it. Chattanooga put some pressure on them, made them turn it over. It's going to be a throw in Chattanooga. Turnover Chattanooga, ball for Memphis. This has been a pretty even game in this first half. Both teams have been very aggressive with trying to not give the other space. And it's basically been a defensive battle, forcing each team to basically make perfect passes and drop the ball just in the right spot. Neither team has been able to do that to enough effect. Well, Chattanooga held on to it for a while, about a good 10 seconds there. The ball was pushed ahead pretty quickly on the quick restart and taken up to the far side, but Tommy was there to get it, but it was passed into the box. All right, that's halftime. 0-0 at the half. Both teams had pretty good possessions, but then the defenses would just collapse and take the ball away. So it's been a pretty even game. It'll be interesting to see if Coach Elliott makes any changes in the second half to hopefully pump some life into this offense. But we'll see how this goes. It's been a very good game so far.
Thank you.
Well, Jenna, you were doing great. You did not miss the goal, and that is the most important thing. So, yes. But we have switched out. We are now on our third camera person here tonight. Move the playhead back. So if you want to see that goal again, just drag the playhead back after you've seen it a bunch of times. Then hit the go live button, and it'll take you back to our action live. All right, I'm seeing a lot of people doubting my announcing in the chats. It was definitely John Finley, and I take a little bit of offense that so many people are doubting me. Well, that was just a really good, well-placed pass. It was a one-on-one with the defender. He got enough space that he could just lob it over Tommy's head into the goal. We're tied up here at 1-1 in the 54th minute.
If I wasn't on the camera, they would have got the goal up.
Chattanooga. If we keep doing that, maybe we'll get that second goal. Some substitutions for both teams. Let the players cool down, get a little bit of water. So I guess the player who subbed in was Snoopy Davidson for Chattanooga. Go! Wow. Good shot. Got through the defense, but it was not quite. Chattanooga about to make a sub here. Juan Hernandez comes out, number three for Chattanooga coming in. Substitution for Memphis. 22 coming in for number. Game ready for later in the season. Good possession there for Memphis. Ball just pushed off to the left side of the frame. Waiting on the ball to get put back in place. Ball boy grabs it off the field. Tommy's going to get it. Maybe we'll have time for one more possession here. As the time clicks down, we'd like to thank everybody for watching here on the stream. Sorry we had the...